Hey guys, it's Lisa, and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm gonna be going through my favorite Verb hair products. I'm gonna be going through them in the order of my hair care routine. I've been affiliated with Verb in the past before, and I have actually shared their products, but in the past, I've only actually used two of their products. I've used their heat protectant, which actually I'm gonna go through again with you today. I've also used their hair oil that's dry. There's two versions. There's like a dry and actually more oily version. So I haven't actually tried that many products. If you guys are not new to the channel, I'm currently in Vancouver, and also hence why this wall is so empty. I haven't actually decorated my room or anything. Prior to coming here, I contacted Verb and I wanted to try more of their products. I feel like I have more hair concerns that I want to solve. So if you guys are not new here, you guys know that one of my biggest issues is fallout, and I always concentrate on that when I'm looking for hair products. But I also have other things that I wanted to try, which I will go into more detail in a second. But basically, prior to me coming to Vancouver, I asked to try a couple more of their products, which they've kindly gifted me. There's also a discount code for you guys as well. So if you guys didn't already know, you can always shop through my link and get 10% off of all Verb hair products directly from their website. So I will leave it down below if you guys like any of the products that I'm mentioning today, and you guys can check it out. Without further ado, I'm gonna get started with my favorite products. I'm going once again in order of my hair care routine. So the first two products I want to talk about is their shampoo and conditioner, and this is the Mild Color Safe. This is pretty much their color line shampoo and conditioner. So this is what it looks like. There's a couple things I like about these products. So number one, I really like the packaging, and why I like the packaging is because I feel like it's a really good size for me to hold. Some shampoo bottles are a little bit too big. The one that I have, I really like personally. The other thing also is that the bottle doesn't get deformed. I feel like some other conditioners and shampoo bottles, like once you press on it, it just gets really, really deformed, whereas this one holds its shape. I know this isn't even that important because it's really all about the product. The second thing that makes this now my holy grail is two things. Obviously, one of them is the fact that it's color safe, and as you guys can see, I have bleached my hair. I needed the color safe option, but the second thing is that I'm about to show you guys kind of a disgusting clip. Just count this as my little disclaimer right here if you don't want to see this. My hair fallout has decreased drastically. So there's this thing that I do in the bathroom when I wash my hair, is I actually like always comb through my hair during conditioner, and I'll actually pull out the hair and hold it and put it against the wall, just because I don't like actually going down to the sink and grabbing that gunk of hair. So I usually just do it while I'm pulling it out, and I'll like stick it onto the wall, so then that way when I exit the shower later, I can just take it from the wall instead of from the drain, which I find is even grosser. So I don't know, just for the sake of proof, you guys, I brought my iPhone into the shower and filmed it. I've been using these products for a month now, and every single time I've used this shampoo and conditioner and I pull out my hair, it's surprisingly so little. Like, I'm not sure if it's because I'm becoming less and less stressed out, I'm in Vancouver, I'm with my parents, I don't know, but like, I don't think it's gonna make that big of a difference in terms of lifestyle, because like usually I grab a lot of hair, like to the point where it concerns me and I feel like I need to go see a doctor or something like that. I don't know if you guys have that issue. That's why fallout is so important to me. But surprisingly, when I use these products and I was like trying to pull my hair out, I'm like, this is it. Like, this is not normal. It does have a lot to do with the shampoo and conditioner. So I highly recommend you guys checking it out, because if you guys are concerned with fallout, this shampoo and conditioner really worked for me. If you guys are also wondering like, oh, Lisa, you talk so much about good and non-fallout shampoos and conditioners, like why don't you just stick with one? So my answer to that, and maybe you guys can correct me if I'm wrong, but ever since I was little, my mom kind of told me that when it comes to shampoo and conditioner, it's better to change your brands frequently. So for me, like I've kind of always gotten into the habit, like I will never use the exact same shampoo and conditioner back to back. I will always switch it, even if I like a brand or a product. So like, for example, I really do like these two. After I finish this, the next one is not gonna be this one. It's gonna be something else. And then I'll come back to it afterwards. But like, I will never use it back to back because I feel like ever since I was little, my mom just trained me to think that it's better to switch up your shampoos and conditioners. And therefore, for me, I don't just like look for one good non-hair fallout shampoo. Like I look for a couple so then I can put them on rotation. So you guys know that, you know, some of my holy grails are the L'Oreal Ever Strong line. It's like the green bottle, that one I really like. Now I'm adding this one to the roster. I think the next shampoo that I'm gonna be using, I'm gonna contact them again and I'm actually gonna try their curly hair line for a couple reasons. Because number one, obviously, like I said, I don't wanna use the exact same one back to back. I think it has something to do with the ingredients. And then the second reason is because if you guys haven't seen my stories lately on Instagram, I've been talking a lot about my natural curl. For my hair, the first two goals I've been maintaining is making sure that my hair doesn't fall out that often or that much. And then the second one is obviously protecting the color because I've dyed my hair and bleached it. But now I feel like I've actually done a really good job keeping those two goals. Like over the years, my hair has become a lot thicker and definitely I've maintained the color really well as well. So I'm moving on to a new hair goal. I want to really love my natural curls. So if you guys didn't already know, my hair is naturally curly. I don't know, I feel like mine is maybe more of a wave. In my ideal world, I don't want to have to curl my hair every other day. Like I want to just be able to rock my natural curl. But my main issue is that my hair is pretty frizzy. It isn't actually all very curly. I think I'm gonna make it my next hair goal to try to see if I can rock my natural curl. And hence, I think the next shampoo I'm gonna try from Verb is probably gonna be from their curly hair line. I will update you guys on that if it works out, but this is just pretty much the goal right now. So anyway, sorry, enough blabbing. This is the shampoo and conditioner that I really like. I'll leave the links all down below, but this is like the color safe option and it's been working really well for me this month. And you guys can see I'm already this much through my shampoo and conditioner. So I think it'll last me maybe a couple more months and then I'm gonna switch up to the curly hairline. The next product that is kind of in order of my hair care routine is the Verb Tone and Brighten and Hydrate Purple Mask. This is what the product looks like. I just wanna make it very clear that this product is a mask and also some sort of like purple, I don't wanna say shampoo because it's not a shampoo, but it's like the idea of a purple shampoo. And honestly, when I saw this on their website, I was like, this is genius. Because you guys know that I am so impatient and I just don't have the time to be in the bathroom for God knows how long to do a purple shampoo and then to do a mask. It's like, oh my God, like I don't have this much time to be just like in the shower. I mean, granted, I do a little karaoke in the shower, but like I just don't have the time of day to do two different waiting arounds. And I feel like this is genius because it's like this can hydrate my hair and tone my hair at once. Like I just don't understand why not more companies have a product like this. Anyway, this is just like a really good time-saving alternative. I mean, granted, if you are looking for ultimate hydration or like ultimate toning, there's probably better products out there, but this one is just like such a good hybrid. So if you guys are looking for some sort of like time saving technique, I would definitely go with this product right here. Man, it's genius. Like I don't know why more companies don't do this. Like the chances of you needing your hair hydrated is probably because you bleached it. So this is literally the combination of both those uses. That's all I have to say about this product. Like I said, when I was coming to Vancouver, I didn't want to bring my purple shampoo and my mask. So when I saw this product online, I pretty much looked at it and I was like, wow, this is genius. So that's pretty much why I got it. I'm very excited for you guys to try it too. Collectively, I haven't used it that often. Like I use it about once a week. So I've used it about 4 times now. Also, for the sake of filming this video, I have also used it again. So far, it's been good. I mean, I leave it in for about 5 minutes or so for more hydration and toning. But like I said, if you're looking for like the ultimate like hardcore, I would definitely go with other brands with like the two separate ones, but this one is just such a good hybrid for you to use. Next up on my list is something that I've already mentioned before. This is the Verb Ghost Prep, and this is their heat protectant and also frizz control. This is what the product looks like. I've already mentioned this product before, and to be honest, when I was coming to Vancouver, I was like, should I try another heat protectant or like another one just for the sake of trying it? But I honestly love this product so much that I was like, nah, I'm just gonna stick with it, and I just like asked for it again. So I already have one in Toronto, and this is my version here in Vancouver. Here's a couple of things that I like about the product and also kind of don't like. The first thing is that this product definitely holds heat really well, and I like how this is a cream because I know a lot of heat protectants are like the spray-ons. I actually don't really like that. I like to comb it through my hair. So that's the first thing that I really like. The second thing is that it does provide a little bit of moisture. That's another reason why I like this product. I think it's part of their Ghost line. So their Ghost line is generally for, you know, the everyday hair. You don't need to have like bleached hair or curly hair. Like, it kind of just works with everybody. It does advertise as frizz control. I find that it is good for frizz control in a sense that I personally thought it worked better when I don't blow dry my hair, and it's better on frizz control that way. And especially if I like put this on and I put my hair in a towel, my curls will be a little bit more defined and less frizzy. However, I do think that as a frizz control product, when I dry my hair, I don't find that it controls my frizz that much. So once again, I think now that I'm on my journey of loving my natural curls and stuff, or trying to love my natural curls, I don't think this product is, you know, the optimal for frizz control. I think it does the other things really well, such as, you know, heat protecting and stuff like that, which I guess kind of makes sense because, like I said, the Ghost line is advertised more for the everyday hair. So for people with like either naturally wavy or naturally curly hair, this isn't so much dedicated to you. So I think that if your hair is either naturally straight or you just have maybe not wavy or curly hair, I think this would be a really ideal product for you. For someone with kind of natural curls like me, I still think it's good for heat protection. And like I said, this is my second bottle now. But in terms of controlling the frizz, and if you're gonna blow dry your hair, I think that there might be a better product. And I will once again let you know, because I've only started this natural curl journey literally like last week, or wanting to. So I will check out their website to see if there's any more curly hair friendly heat protectant slash, you know, frizz control products on their website. But if you're watching this video and you have, you know, naturally straight hair, I very much recommend this for you especially. The next product that I wanted to talk about is their Verb Ghost Oil. This is what it looks like. So the one hair oil that I've tried before, like I said in the introduction, is their dry oil. And the difference is this one is obviously your classic hair oil, a bottle of oil, you put it on your hands, rub it together, and then comb it through your hair. The other one is more of a spray-on. I actually really liked the spray-on because it didn't leave my hair that greasy or my hands, which I really like, and I honestly think it's a cool concept, and I feel like you guys should definitely try it out. When I was coming here, I wanted to try their regular oil and see how that went. For me, I personally need to definitely put on a lot more product just because, like I said, as a naturally curly hair person, my hair tends to be a lot more frizzy. So all the clips that you guys are seeing in this video, even with me like putting it on, I literally just washed my hair and did this whole hair care routine. So it's fresh in my brain when I'm describing to you what I'm doing. And this is what it looks like. I use this product twice. So I use it when my hair is damp, and I'll put on the frizz control slash heat protectant that I just showed you. Then I'll put on my Ghost oil, and then after my hair is dry and after I curl my hair, I'll put my Ghost oil on again. I don't know if you guys can see, but like, it's just so silky, which I really like. Back to what I was saying, I think that in terms of the Ghost oil versus the dry oil, my at the end recommendation is this. If you have natural curl, etc., I think this product might be better for you because you can put on a lot more. Your hair isn't like that big of a victim of oiliness. Like for me, because I have natural curl, I think I'm not as scared of getting my hair oily as much as maybe like straight hair people do. So if you have straight hair, I personally would try the dry oil because I love the product, but I think like I needed to use a lot of it just because, like I said, my hair tends to be very easily frizzy. So if you also have very easily frizzy hair, I would recommend this one over the dry oil, unless if you just want to try it for the concept, which I still think is really cool. That's pretty much my end-to-end recommendation. I hope that makes sense and if that was helpful to you since I've tried them both. So the last product that I wanted to talk about, this is what their dry shampoo looks like. So this is their Gentle Cleanse Style Extender Light Volume Dry Shampoo, and here's the key part: for dark hair. This is the thing. I hate dry shampoo. Like, not from Verb or anyone, it's just I genuinely hate dry shampoo. I know this is like a very controversial statement because I know a lot of people that love dry shampoo, but for me, like, I don't feel clean still, even after I use dry shampoo. Like, if I have really oily hair, I can't put on dry shampoo and then go to bed. Like, I can't, I'm sorry. But do I think, even if you also hate dry shampoo in general, like me, do you need the product? Yes. It's like, do you hate tampons? Yes. Do you need tampons? Probably. So it's like, for me, like, okay, if you love dry shampoo, this is probably irrelevant to you, but even if you hate dry shampoo, you just need it. Unless if you're washing your hair every single damn day, which is obviously not good for you. For me, I try to wash my hair every other day or sometimes every 2 days. If I do every 2 days, on the last day, I just feel like midway through the day, I get very self-conscious and I'm like, oh my God, does my hair smell? But like, I'm already out and it's too late. By the time I regret not washing it the night before, I'm like, crap. So that's when I'll need dry shampoo. I don't think this is ever a product that you're like, oh my God, like I want it. But it's more just like your hair is oily and you're self-conscious and you just need to put it on. For me, like, this is just a must-have in general, unless, like I said, you wash your hair every day, which you shouldn't. Therefore, at the end of the day, you still need dry shampoo. For me, I really like this product because it's not that oily. Obviously, it does get rid of the oiliness and the smell until I can last throughout the day, and then at night I'll wash my hair. The best part about this is that I find that all the other dry shampoos that I've had, every time I spray it on, the issue is that I'll have the white streaks, and like sometimes if I'm not looking carefully, I don't blend it well, and then I go outside and I look like an idiot. So this one, I have filmed a little video to show you guys like the color that comes out, but this is dark, which is so ideal. If you're like me and you're not sure if you blend it out properly, this is such a great product for you because I don't trust myself and I don't think I blend my hair properly. So using this is definitely such a great solution for me in terms of just like getting the product through my hair and not looking that I just tried dry shampooing to save my life. All in all, definitely get their dry shampoo. There is also obviously like a version for people with lighter color hair, but for all my other dark hair friends, this one is such a holy grail, so I highly recommend this product as well. That is pretty much all my favorites from Verb so far. Like I said, I am going to be trying a lot more of their products, hopefully in the upcoming months, so I can definitely update you guys as well. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and also the notification button, that way you don't miss another video. And especially in my monthly favorites, I always do kind of like products here and there. The only reason why these products didn't make it to my monthly favorites is because there was just so many from the same brand that I was like, I might as well just do one whole video on it. But anyway, as I said, if you guys liked any of these products, you guys can get 10% off using my link down below. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!